One of the biggest complaints I hear from homeschool moms every single day is that they don't have enough time to get it all done. We're constantly in the middle of switching over laundry, grading papers, prepping for meals. We don't have time to sit and connect with every kid. We don't have time for fun or rest, and we don't take time for prayer. They're not taking time for themselves to rest, to exercise, to connect with the Lord, let alone connect with each of their children on a daily basis, which is really at the heart of what they deeply want. This comes down to two main issues that you could easily solve today with one simple tweak with how you're thinking about your time and how you're implementing what you want to do on any given day. My name is Emily Brown, and I'm a life coach for Catholic homeschool moms who want to have more peace and confidence in their homeschooling relationships and lifestyle. You can take one of my free masterclasses called How to Stop Yelling and Start Connecting. This is going to be a free class for you to watch on demand to help you go deeper in connecting with your kids so that you can stop overreacting and have more of those intentional relationships that you deeply desire. And when your relationships are feeling more pleasurable and more relaxed in your homeschooling day, then homeschooling becomes so much more simple. You can find a link for that and all of the information about my life coaching work for Catholic homeschool moms in the links below this video. The two main issues that you're likely dealing with that it could explain the experience you're having in your homeschooling lifestyle are that you're not prioritizing what you want to get done on any given day, and then you're not planning for how you're going to make those things happen. That's it. It's actually that simple. So the strategy I teach in the Happy Holy Mama membership is a concept I call mom's office hours. If you were a teacher in a brick and mortar school or a university, you would have set aside time called prep time or office hours. That is time that is going to be solely dedicated to you as a teacher to prepare your next classes, to prepare your next week, to do research, to connect with colleagues, to answer questions from your students either in person or online, and to go deeper into concepts whenever students have something that they need to talk to you about. As homeschoolers, this is significantly more challenging because we have babies and toddlers. We have extracurricular activities. We have meals to prep. We have laundry to turn over. We have meat to thaw for dinner tonight. We wear all of the hats. And so the best way for you to fit it all in is to think about what it is you want to get done today and then set time aside to do it. So one way you can do that is with mom's office hours. Mom's office hours is going to be time that you set aside to get the things done that you want to get done. But here's the trick. You have to be willing to be interrupted during that time. This is time where you're going to give your children permission to bring you their work that they've been working on independently, or to finish up from something you've taught them earlier in the day that they would like for you to look over. And it's going to be the time when you stop everything else you're doing and switch into that mode. So it's going to be where you put down the papers that you were grading. It's going to be where you stop switching over the laundry. It's going to be where you set aside everything else that you've decided to do during that time in order to connect with this child and to prioritize their homeschooling and educational materials first, their questions and the things that they want to go deeper on. When you have that time set aside, then what that allows you to do is say yes to the children in that time and say no to everything else. And here's the beautiful part, is that once that time is over, say you've decided from 1 to 3 p.m., then once 3 p.m. hits, then mom's office hours are now closed. And so what you've decided is that at 3 p.m., all of the homeschooling related questions and assignments and things that they want you to look over, all of that now needs to wait until tomorrow or the next time you're going to be doing homeschooling. And now at this time at 3 p.m., if that's your chosen time, now is the time where mom is going to move on with her day and do other things that are going to help us move on with our life and feel very successful at the end of our day. A simple boundary that you might want to implement with your children if you choose to implement office hours is, if you have questions or assignments that you want me to look over that are specifically homeschooling related, you need to bring those to me during the hours of 1 to 3 p.m. If you do not bring that work to me between the hours of 1 and 3 p.m., then unfortunately, that assignment, those questions are going to need to wait until tomorrow. It's actually a very simple boundary, and all it takes is your willingness to experiment and to try with this and to allow your children to live with the consequences of your no. And this can be a very beneficial thing for them to be able to learn to manage their own time, to be able to come and meet your own deadlines, the deadlines that you provide for them, not just deadlines that another program provides for them. Our home is a very low-risk environment for them to learn these lessons. So I want you to think about when you're considering implementing office hours and these boundaries to protect your time. I want you to think about what are some of the things that you will benefit from with this, and how will this also benefit your children in the long run? And then what do all of you need in order to be successful at this? Think about that ahead of time so that you can have all of that decided and all those obstacles already navigated before you implement this. All right, some things I want you to think about when you are considering implementing office hours. Mom's office hours are not the same thing as working one-on-one with a child. That is time where you are teaching them a concept, where you're working with them one-on-one, and that is going to be time you set aside at a different time of your day. Mom's office hours is going to be time when you have dedicated specifically to answering their questions, to grading their work, to researching and prepping your next homeschool day or your next homeschool week or project, looking up field trips, reserving books on the library website, a whole host of things that you have always wanted to get to, but you don't seem to have time for. You could be doing things around the home as long as you don't mind being interrupted. So again, thawing meat for dinner or switching over the laundry or, you know, playing with a toddler, whatever you don't mind being interrupted with, those are things that you could say yes to during mom's office hours. But again, this is not the same time that you would be using to work with a child one-on-one for their main teaching portion or that main working time where you're side by side and working through their work together. A couple of other things to keep in mind. You don't necessarily need office hours every single day. You also don't necessarily need the same amount of time every day, and you don't need to have them at the same time of every day. I highly recommend thinking about this at the beginning of every morning and asking yourself, what do I need to set a time aside for today, and when do I want to have time to do that? Thinking about and prioritizing your own time first is going to help you get all the things, the most important things done every single day. It's going to help you say yes to those things and no to other things, especially the little things that tend to pop up and distract us from doing the things we said we were going to do. This is going to help you build trust with yourself and help your children learn how to trust you and to do what you say you're going to do, which is one of the most valuable lessons that they're ever going to learn and is going to help you enhance and improve your relationships over time. Office hours need to be decided ahead of time, and they need to be communicated clearly to your kids, either in the morning at breakfast or at morning time whenever you're all together, or you could post it on a whiteboard or on a calendar for the day, just somewhere where your children know what is coming up, know what to expect so that they can plan their time accordingly to meet your own deadlines and to meet your rules for them. When you implement office hours, I want you to consider that this is time for you, that this is time that you get to have to set aside to do the things you said you were going to do the things that the Lord has placed on your heart to do. I want you to think about the same concept, implying it to mom's prayer time, to applying it to mom's meal prep time, and mom's homeschool planning time first thing in the morning. I want you to think about how you can say yes to what it is you've decided, what it is the Lord has placed on your heart to do, and how you can say no to other things more easily because you've decided what it is you want, you've prioritized that in your day, and because now you have planned ahead to be able to get it done. If you would like to talk to me more about how to do this work, how to implement these concepts, and how to be consistent in following through with them, then I want to encourage you to come and join me in the Happy Holy Mama membership. This is my life coaching program for Catholic homeschool moms who want to have more peace and more self-confidence to improve your relationships and to enjoy this homeschooling journey and lifestyle so much more. You can find all the details for the Happy Holy Mama membership in the links below this video. And while you're down there, please like and subscribe to this channel so that you can get notified every single month when I release new life coaching content geared specifically to your Catholic homeschooling lifestyle. I'm praying for you. I hope you have a fantastic week. God bless.